Hello, this is Formula Offroad. Round 6, the final round of the Icelandic Championship. Now, the final race was held in Akranes, and 15 cars were entered. This is the final race before the Formula Offroad USA. Guðmundur Ingi Arnarsson, he clinched the title in last round in Egilstaðir. However, the race was on for second place, where Atli Jamil was hunting down Thor Thormar. Thor Thormar needed to get a good race to clinch second place.
Guðmundur, you clinched the title in the last race. How will you drive today?
Just like every race.
Just flat out?
Yes, flat out.
And the courses are quite tricky here today, aren't they?
Yes, I'm on the front in first two tracks, and then they are very tricky.
Yeah, so you're not predicting many points from you in the first two tracks?
No, I don't think so, but we try to get as much points as we get and try to win up.
Yeah, and you try to get better results in the later courses?
Yes.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
Atli, you were always a little bit behind the front runners in Egilstaðir. What will it take to take the victory today?
Just need to be a little bit aggressive. Yeah.
And the tracks are quite tricky here today.
Yeah, a lot of turns and deep hills.
Yeah. And you have good turns and a lot of power, so this must suit you.
Yeah, that probably will help, but the hills are a little bit slippery.
And how are you going to drive today? Just flat out?
We'll do the best.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Haukur, you made some changes to the car for this race.
Yes, we put the more steering radio, so he can turn more to left or right.
And have you tested the car with this, with more turns?
Yeah, we tested yesterday and it was fine, working well, and he was really good on the hills.
But do you think you will need some time to adjust to this new system in this race?
I don't know, maybe not. I think I know what I'm gonna do, but I'm not sure. We can see it.
But the tracks today are very tricky. How are you gonna drive today? Just flat out?
I think it's best to drive flat out today. It's very hard and you need much power to go up, I think, every tracks.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
Full throttle all in. A lot of power for the tracks. This is Haukur. He's taking on track number one first. Here we have... There's a steep and a tough bank right away, and Haukur not going all in right away. The tracks are very hard. Here we have Valdimar Sveinsson. He only gets 80 points as well. This is Magnus Sigurðsson driving the cube. He had a bad day in Egilstaðir, and he doesn't go up either. But he gets 90 points, a little bit further than the rest. This is Númi Aðalbjörnsson, Green Thunder, 50 points. I don't remember a lot of tracks that were this tough. Here's Thor Thormar. He's gonna go for it. He goes for it. And that ends in a roll, no! And that's another save! I think we have best in show. Well, right away, in the first track. He's happy with that, 80 points, but that was just amazing driving. And the track was very hard, and no one went any further in track number one, so we're now looking at track number two. Thor Thormar again. That's trickier than it maybe looks. There's a race that he needs to get into here. And bit of a struggle there. Thor Thormar was close to winning the race in Egilstaðir, but messed it up in the time attack. He gets up now. He's got some penalty points. And that's a lot of penalty points. 234 length, that's 110 points after penalty points. Here's the champion, and that's not the champion way, but does manage to release it. That's 40 penalty points. But will he get over when he tries again? Yep, that's better. Gets a good landing there, managed to stop it, and therefore he can really line it up for the next obstacle. But not looking good there. Goes below the gate, and that's out of bounds. That's 140 points, so he didn't get a lot of penalties. Here's Gabriel Grimsson. He's stuck, and that he won't be able to back out of that. Now, Haukur does the same. Elias, same. They can see their rivals doing that. This is Hafsteinn Thorvaldsson. He was going to go all the way, but not well done. Nume, same. Akranes seems to be pretty tough. This is Magnus Sigurdsson. He's over. That's a bit amazing after everything we watched, because we've seen this car get beat quite a few times. He's, oh, goes all in. That's well done. And will he go all the way? He's not got a lot of traction there. No, no, won't go all the way. 150 points for length, but he can be pretty pleased with that. Here is Atli Jamil Ásgeirsson. This is Thunderbolt. Yeah, does well there. Maybe the bank's getting a little bit smaller with these cars driving on it. Sometimes the tracks get harder, sometimes they get easier, as we have more cars going through, and Atli goes all the way. No, not quite. Not quite. This is Elva Stefansdóttir, the only female in this race. But she gets stuck. And her first ever race. But she did go all in a little bit later. And managed to save there. Great, great show there. And she gets a round of applause from the spectators. Yep, she was did quite well, and she came to prove that Formula Offroad is not a sport only for men, and we truly, truly hope that we see more of Elva in Formula Offroad. She had fun, and we did as well. Now, track number two, back to that. This is one of the later cars in the starting order. Birgir has not had a good summer, but it's only his first year. Will he manage to maneuver it here? Yeah, gets to the 20 penalty points, but the final gate is quite hard. No, no, he needs more speed, a lot more speed. So that's 180 points, and that's the highest points from this track. So let's see the standings. Magnus Sigurdsson, Atli Jamil, and Birgir equal for first place.
Magnus, how did it go for you the first two tracks?
I think it was okay. It was very tough, and but very few points. So it's pretty hard tracks now.
And how do you like the tracks after Lundsbrück?
They are pretty good. I think next one is okay, but I'm not sure how many cars will go over the end.
And then you have a little bit of a trick in the fourth course.
Yes, I have something. If the third track will be okay to go 350 points, then I know a way I can go easily through the gate at number four.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Yep, pretty pleased with the morning. Here we have Svanur Tómasson. He was in fifth place, pretty close to the top. But this mistake was costly. Backs it up, but doesn't manage to get up. So that's only 50 points total. And that's Svanur completely out of the race for the win. Haukur Einarsson goes all the way up there. Now he needs to maneuver to the second gate. They could choose their way, but Haukur is too aggressive there. And when you're facing sideways in these steep parts, they can be tricky. Thor needs to build up some points here, and that's not the way to do it. But he backs, goes again, rolls through the gate. That's, well, an odd roll. But he waves to the crowd. So a wave, but then a kick, because he knows that was bad. Here's Atli Jamil Ásgeirsson. He's trying to clinch second place in the championship away from Thor Þormar. So far, nobody has finished, well, getting full points for length. Let's see if Atli can do it here. Full throttle, and that's all the way up. And that's the first man in Akranes to finish a track. 230 points after penalties. It is Grimdrinki taking a weird route. Nothing working out. Reverses and goes again for again, but tries to take the same back for some reason. And that's only 40 points. Grimdur not on it in Akranes. Here we have the leader. But Magnus doesn't even try. Gets 160 points. That means that Atli Jamil leads. This is track number 4, Númi Aðalbjörnsson. A car that has been racing in Formula Offroad for many, many, many years with another driver. But Númi found out that track number 4 was quite easy until the final bank. Big roll for Númi. See it again here. This car is quite used to big rolls. This is Haukur Thorvaldsson. Two brothers racing, Haukur and Hafstedt. And they have very different exhaust systems to the other cars, which you can hear from the sound. But Haukur gets 220 points. This is Hafstedt, his brother. Hafstedt, a former Icelandic champion. They do go all the way. Yep, did. And shot some rocks at our cameraman. Managed to get over. Here is Valdimar Jón Sveinsson. Struggling, needs more speed there. He's gonna reverse. Will that be enough to get him through the gate? Yes, he does. 350 points for length. At 90 penalty points. Birgir Sigurðsson, he was close to the lead, was fighting for the win, which is something that he has not done before. Will he go all the way? Yes, he does. 350 points for length, 50 penalty points, and his team very pleased with Birgir. Now this is Haukur. Will he manage to get Hekla over the ridge? A lot of wheel spin, and that's well done. 350 points for length, 30 penalty points. So, 20 penalty points. So, 330 points. Magnus Sigurðsson, he lost his lead in track, in the last track. And got, was in second place before this one and did well. Atli Jamil. He needs to go all the way without penalties, but he doesn't go all the way. Only 200 points for Atli Jamil, which means that Magnus Sigurðsson takes the lead again. However, Atli stays in second place, and Birgir Sigurðsson is third. Haukur Einarsson is fourth. Hafsteinn Þórðarson is fifth. And as you can see, well, this man here, Grimdrinki, not in the top five. All in here, that's a nice drive though, although he gets penalty points. That's the 100 point gate. Needs to go over this ditch here. 80 penalty points for not going through. And he has a lot of penalty points. It's too low here. You can see the gate there. The white stick is the lower part of the gate. Don't give me the nose in. What? Nope, he's not gonna try. 224 length, 120 penalty points, only 100 points. This is Geirert Grímsson. He does well as well. That's beautiful looking at these cars taking this one. He's gonna take the ditch. He is in trouble. Will he manage to get out of it? This is gonna need something special. He's not. Oh, yep. That was always threatening to roll. So, low points here in Akranes. Atli Amil, he's leading. Was second, sorry. And looking for the lead. Only 90 points and 40 penalty points, or only 50 penalty points. Birgir Sigurðsson misses the gate. The left front axle broke. And that means that the car wouldn't steer. Now, Magnus Sigurðsson, he can almost clinch the win here if he goes all the way. He can at least do well to extend his lead. Here's the ditch. Does it quite different? This is so steep. Is he gonna back out of it? He's not sure what he's doing. He's quit. He's out. 110 points. However, that was the highest point tally for this track. Here's Ingólfur Guðrason. Let's roll. Things not going his way. 80 points. We're on board. The worst rolls are the rolls that happen so slowly. And a lot of dirt and dust. It is Elias. He takes a different line to everybody, goes up there. He managed to clinch third place in the first race this year, but nothing really done after. He released the rear-wheel drive there and didn't manage to connect it back again. It looks like the rear wheel's not spinning, or he missed a gear. Here we have the time attack. Magnus Sigurðsson, he can clinch the win here. This is the last track. If he just finishes this track in proper fashion, he will win this race. He won one race last year or the year before, so this will be his second win, and he's doing it well here, and that means that he clinches the win in Akranes. However, Atli Jamil, he was fighting to try to catch the win. However, he was mainly trying to go for the second place in the championship. Big jump. Lucky not to roll it. And that's a nice spin to turn around. But he lost time and finished the race in third. But Magnus, a happy, happy man. It's a little bit dirtier than we see in the track racing. Let's see the final standing. Magnus Sigurðsson wins. Haukur Einarsson, second. Atli Jamil Ásgeirsson was third. Birgir Sigurðsson, fourth. And Geirert Grímsson, fifth. And that means that Atli Jamil manages to beat Thor Þormar to second place. Guðmundur Arnarsson clinched the championship. But let's hear from Magnus.
Hey Magnus, congratulations with the first place.
Thank you.
How do you describe your driving today? Was it just okay, or?
I think I just take a fewest penalty points. We were all driving similar distance.
So yeah, the key is just to drive safe and not damage the car.
Yes, I had one broken drive shaft, but that's all.
And you had a pretty terrible race in Egilstadir, the last race. How's the feeling like being on top here today?
Yeah, this is very good. Last time it was very bad, but now I did a little bit changed driving style, and I saw the circumstances were similar, so now I know how to drive when we have like this.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Magnus, a happy man. Now let's quickly look at the street legal class. This man, Ragnar Skúlason, He only need to show up to become champion. So through the first gate, Ragnar becomes the Icelandic champion this season. He's done very well all summer. And well, it's funny to say that that's not his car. He borrowed it for this season. And this car, but this car has been champion for the last few years in the hands of Ivar. Ragnar Skúlason tries for the same team as Guðmundur Ingi, the champion in the Swede Legal in the Unlimited class. So they now have a title in both classes. And there you can see him, a happy man, champion. He knows it. Didn't need to do any more. It's probably a bit weird to win the championship after one track, but that's the way it is. However, Ragnar Skúlason didn't win it. It was this man here, Skúli Kristinsson. He drove the car that Edvald Orri has been driving this summer and borrowed the car for this final race. Did a fantastic job and won the race. He also won here last year, driving this car, so he has 100% win record for both the races that he has entered. And the gossip says that he is building a car to field the full race program next year. Might very likely be going for the title. Good driving here. Now let's see the final standings in the Iceland Championship. Ragnar Skúlason is the champion, Steingrimur Bjarnason second, and Haukur Birgisson third. Now this was the final race of the Icelandic Formula Offroad summer. However, in October, Formula Offroad takes on the big leap over the Atlantic, over the pond, and will race in Bikini Bottoms, a one-off race in October in Tennessee. Formula Offroad USA was a great spectacle last year, and we don't expect it to be any less this year. Now, next time around, however, we will show you from the Rally Reykjavík, the International Rally of Reykjavík. My name is Kristján Einar, and thank you and goodbye. I haven't got a clue.